The Sputnik that the Russians launched changed the whole aspect of America's space attempts.
I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving the goal, before this decade is out, of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the Earth.
Everybody changed gears at that point. The entire nation was now geared to make the Kennedy statement a truth. The Apollo program was set up as an endgame thing to get men on the moon and return them safely. But to get there, you have to learn to walk before you can run. And the preliminary things involved in doing that were projects that brought the experience up a level each time. And so the steps were taken one at a time. NASA would release these requests for proposals. All of the major aerospace companies of the United States would jump and would then issue their proposals. And that started an intense competition among the major aerospace contractors in the United States. And Grumman was not one of the big players, but the competition for the lunar program ended with the last contract to be awarded, and that was for the spacecraft, the Lunar Excursion Module.
Because it used to be LEM, which was Lunar Excursion Module. The command module was CM, service module was SM, so they made the lunar module LM. So they dropped the E.
And the task was to bring two men onto the surface of the moon, allow them to climb out, wander around, steal some rocks, and then come back home with their package of goodies.
You start out with a gigantic 6.5 million pound rocket, and you come home with about 30,000 plus pounds in one capsule that will splash down in the Pacific Ocean. Between those two events, you had dozens of events that had to take place and had to be successful in order for the mission not to be aborted each time.
We were developing technology that had never been used before.
The programs at the Cape, which only a few years ago were science fiction, are today becoming science fact.
The proposal was a nightmare. It was a two-month effort from July to Labor Day 1962. After several reports during the months preceding, the proposal request was issued by NASA. They had specific questions they wanted answered. They said 50 pages, no more. 10-point type, no less. And so we had to have all these restrictions in addition to the words that are going to explain how it is that we're going to build this spacecraft. And a day before Election Day 62, President Johnson announced that the winning proposal for the last jewel in the crown, as far as I was concerned, was Grumman Aerospace Corporation. We won the proposal, we did it. So that was the onset of Grumman's odyssey.
No single space project in this period will be more impressive to mankind or more important for the long-range exploration of space.